is Sunday the 31st of May, and just having a look at the commodities, starting off with gold. So I'd highlighted an area here on the daily where I was looking for gold to ideally kind of come back into here. It's hit a little bit lower, but it still looks relatively bullish there. I like the look of that weekly candle. We still are not that overextended, and we're still very close to 1800 level. So my expectation this week is certainly for that to attempt to go back up to that level. Silver, on the other hand, did deliver as promised. Very nicely, a beautiful swing low, and starting to head up and looking very nice and bullish. And that is a little bit overextended on the weekly. And as I said, there's just some key levels to be concerned about. But if gold follows through, there's no reason why silver won't just continue onwards with that. So that looks good. Crude oils as well, beautifully, have also followed through, broken these highs as well. You could see a nice solid retracement happening on that monthly downtrend back up into the moving averages and back up into levels of support and potential resistance. Now, of course, the risk is getting slightly higher. I'm still bullish on them on the daily in terms of the shorter term, but I'm also aware that we're now starting to enter into that dangerous territory. That's looking at US crude, West Texas intermediates as well, starting to pull back up into those areas. So I'll just be more cautious as we go. We're now entering into that area. So I quite like the look of this. It's pretty much the same across Brent, US, and West Texas. Just going to identify those key levels and looking for shorter term, perhaps even just intraday, lower time frame opportunities. But I quite like this. We've now just broken through that resistance. And currently, at least on the daily in isolation, looks really nice and healthy. But that may ultimately end. We have got crude oil inventories out this week. We've also got unemployment figures and employment figures. So it's going to be a very... and of course, we've got all the civil unrest in the US, which is... partially justified in terms of police brutality. So there's a lot of stuff going on, and of course a lot of misinformation and stoking the fires, and it's a bit of a dumpster fire at the moment, but I think that is probably a healthy thing, and that's my personal opinion, by the way. So just a bit of a healthy thing. I think there's a lot of dissatisfaction with the current administration, and I think it's starting to bubble over. So I think this is probably a good thing. But having said that, my point was that there's a lot of, this week is going to be an interesting one historically, without a doubt. Not just the economic figures, I think those will just be interesting, but certainly I think socially what's going on is very important, and if you're not paying attention, you should. That's it in terms of those. Let's go on to sugar. Was quite interesting. So sugar, I've taken a trade long. This was something I posted on LinkedIn. It has followed through, not a really strong commitment, but we'll see how it then plays out this week, and I'll catch up on that next week. And then Bitcoin, taking another run at that 10,000 level. Not a lot of buyers in this area, so it's kind of slow and sluggish to do it. You can see there's some resistance at that 9780 level. But that weekly last week's candle looking really nice and bullish as well. And the monthly looks great. Okay, so all of this implying that there's enough momentum to push it over the 10,000 line. And Ether beautifully just broke over that line, 217. This was during the week last week, and gapped up. It may come down and close the gap. I'm not sure yet if it's going to be able to do that. Looking good, and actually the next level was 250. It's almost at 250 anyway. So a pullback at some point in the near future looking good, and we'll see if it can hold and stay above this level. And we'll see if the markets head low, of course, so we can see commodities drop. We'll also see digital commodities drop as well. So I think this week there may be potential volatility in the markets. And so just caution, I'll be taking shorter term trades. And if I do take any nice trades that I have the foresight to record, I will do that as well. Thank you.